You are not ordinary. You have the blessing. God's face is smiling on you. He's going before you right now, making crooked places straight, moving the wrong people out of the way, arranging things in your favor. When you know you have the blessing, you don't go around upset because people aren't treating you right, worried about your finances, frustrated over your child. You stay in peace knowing that it's just a matter of time before things change. You know God being for you is more than the world being against you. When you're tempted to be discouraged, think it's never going to work out. Turn it around. Father, thank you for the blessing on my life. Thank you that you're breathing in my direction. Thank you that you're taking me where I could not go on my own. God has the right breaks, the right people lined up for you. You don't have to live frustrated, trying to make things happen, worried that it's not going to work out. God is directing your steps. He is going to have you at the right place, at the right time, down to the split second. You're not going to miss what belongs to you. Opportunity is coming bigger than you've imagined. What you think is the ultimate blessing, God showing out in your life. Can I tell you? You haven't seen anything yet. That is just a step in where God is taking you. There are levels that you have not even fathomed. Opportunities far beyond what you think. You may have seen God's goodness in the past. You can say, like me, that God blessed you, but you haven't touched the surface of what God has in store. Proverbs says, a good person leaves an inheritance that their children's children. That's God's dream for you. Get rid of a barely get by mentality. I'll be satisfied if I can just pay my bills and make it through. That's not your destiny. The blessing on your life is going to cause you to lend and not borrow, to have more than enough. David said, "My cup runs over." There are some running over blessings in your future, blessings that you cannot contain, increase that you cannot use up in your lifetime. Well, you would say, I haven't seen any of these far out blessings. Stay encouraged. They're on the way. You wouldn't be hearing this if God wasn't about to do something amazing. He's wanting us to take the limits off Him, enlarge your vision. Quit telling yourself all the reasons why it's not going to happen. How you've had too many bad breaks. How your dream looks impossible. It may be to you, but it's not to our God. Start expecting His favor. Start believing for new levels. Start talking like it's going to happen. Father, thank you that you're bringing me into overflow. Thank you that your generational blessings are coming my way. Thank you that you're opening doors that no man can shut. We see this blessing in the life of Joseph. As a teenager, God gave him a dream that one day he would lead a nation, that people will bow down before him. He knew something big was in his future, but his brothers were jealous. They threw him into a pit. They were going to leave him there to die. But they saw a caravan of Ishmaelites coming. They sold him as a slave. He ended up working for a man named Potiphar. Potiphar was a high-ranking military official in the Egyptian government. And Joseph could have been bitter. God, I thought the blessing was on my life. Why did this happen to me? Instead, he kept being his best, treating people with respect, doing more than required. The scripture says, the Lord was with Joseph and blessed him greatly as he served in the home of his Egyptian master. Notice, God was with Joseph in the unfair situation when he was mistreated. When he was betrayed, the blessing was still on his life. Sometimes we think we are not blessed. We came down with an illness. We lost our main client. Our relationship didn't work out. That didn't stop the blessing. People can't change what God put on you. The favor didn't cancel out because of a bad break. The blessing is why those enemies cannot defeat you. The blessing is why that sickness can't take your life. The blessing is why that setback is not the end. It is a setup for what God is about to do. Don't get discouraged when life doesn't go your way. The blessing is still on you. Verse 3 says, Potiphar noticed Joseph and realized the Lord was giving him success in everything he did. Verse 4, so Joseph naturally became the favorite of Potiphar. Joseph went from being a slave, unnoticed, insignificant, to being the favorite. Potiphar was so impressed that he put Joseph in charge of his whole house. That's the power of the blessing. When people try to push you down, it will cause you to rise up. When people ignore you and try to discount you, it will cause you to be noticed. I'm sure Potiphar had other working people for him that had more experience, but the blessing on Joseph's life caused him to stand out. And people may not recognize you yet. Your boss doesn't give you credit. Relatives discount you, think you don't have much to offer. You may be overlooked now, but the time is coming where you're going to be noticed. People are going to recognize your gifts, your talent, your value. God is going to cause you to stand out. You're going to go from being unnoticed to being in charge, from being not recognized to being the favorite. How could this happen? The blessing in your life. Verse 5 says, the day Joseph was put in charge, God began to bless Potiphar for Joseph's sake. You would think Joseph would be blessed because of Potiphar, this prominent official. It was just the opposite. The blessing on your life is so powerful, it will not only cause you to be promoted, you to be noticed, but people around you will be blessed. Your company, your coworkers, your friends should be glad to have you. Because you're there, they're going to see favor. They're going to see increase. They may not even realize the reason they're blessed is because that they're connected to you. You may have people that don't really value who you are, and they haven't kept their word. Don't be offended. Be a Jacob. Keep doing the right thing. You don't have to convince people to like you. Prove to them who you are. They may discount you now, but one day, like Jacob, they'll be asking you to stay. They will realize the reason they're blessed is because of you. Laban said to Jacob, I'll pay you whatever you want if you will stay. Jacob knew his time there was over. He left, not only a very wealthy man, but he left with the respect and honor that he had not been given for many years. God is your vindicator. He sees what's happening. You keep doing the right thing, and one day, God will make it up to you. And no, you don't need people's approval. You don't need their support. But God is a God of justice. He sees what's happening. If you will keep honoring Him, there will be a day when those who have overlooked you, those that have discounted you, they will see you in a new light and give you the respect and honor that you deserve. When Joseph's brothers threw him into the pit, they took his freedom, but they didn't take the blessing. When Potiphar's wife tried to seduce Joseph, she ripped off his coat and lied about him, falsely accused him. She took his coat, but she couldn't take his calling. Somebody may have hurt you. They betrayed you. They left you out. But they didn't stop your destiny. Quit focusing on what you've lost and start focusing on what you have left. The blessing is still on your life. You are blessed in the city and blessed in the country. You are blessed when you go in and blessed when you come out. That means you are blessed when things are going your way and blessed when they are not going your way. You are blessed when you are in the palace and you are still blessed when you're in the pit. Here's the key. The blessing did not come from people, so it cannot be taken away by people. I have never seen anyone who tried to stop me, discredit me, keep me from my purpose, continue to succeed. It may have been a year, 5 years, 10 years, but eventually they fade out and I'm still standing. It's because the blessing is more powerful than the curse. Whatever's coming against you, whatever people are trying to stop you, they may seem bigger, more powerful. The sickness, the addiction, it can be intimidating. Stay in peace. The blessing God put on you is more powerful than what's trying to stop you. In the scripture, King Saul was trying to kill David. David hadn't done anything wrong. In fact, David was being good to Saul. But Saul was jealous, chased David through the desert, making his life miserable. Several times, David had the opportunity to take Saul's life. He snuck up on him while he was sleeping. He could have ended the conflict, defended himself. Nobody would have blamed him. David wouldn't do it. He knew Saul had been anointed by God to be the king, and even though David was anointed to replace him, he still wouldn't harm Saul. He understood you don't touch God's anointed. You don't come against what God has blessed. When you face opposition, people come against you. You don't have to get upset. Try to pay them back. You can stay in peace knowing that when they come against you, they are touching God's anointed. That means it's not your battle. The battle is the Lord's. He's your defender. He's your vindicator. You are like Joseph at times. We'll get thrown into a pit. Somebody may betray you, but they cannot keep the blessing down. They meant it for harm. God's turning it for good. Keep your shoulders back. Live with confidence. You have an advantage, the blessing in your life. And I believe and declare this blessing is going to take you further than you've imagined. You're about to see far out opportunity, far out promotion, far out favor, the fullness of your destiny in Jesus' name.